Now please pay more attention to the following word phrases. Fry up, 加热 For example, fry up the food, please. 请把这食物加热。Fry, 英文是 own fat. Fry, 英文是 own fat. 自作自受。You deserve it. You fry in your own fat. Okay. Have other fish to fry. 这个口语的表达方式很重要，表示另有要事。For example, Hello, Lucy. Let's go have dinner. Oh, that's a good idea, but I have other fish to fry. Thank you very much. Okay, next, fat. Put on fat. 长胖。On fat 还是一个形容词。胖的，但是我们轻易不用到这个形容词，因为在运用这个形容词的时候很不礼貌，所以常用 large, heavy, overweight 去替代它。那 next important word, abuse, 辱骂、滥用。Don't abuse your authority, 不要辱骂你的上级、上司。Don't abuse your authority. He greeted his wife with a stream of abuse. He greeted his wife with a stream of abuse. 他骂妻子的声音是不绝于耳啊。Okay, next. Luxury. 奢侈品。The diamond ring is a luxury to me. 这钻戒对我来说可是件奢侈品。The diamond ring is a luxury to me. 注意其形容词形式 luxurious, L-U-X-U-R-I-O-U-S, 奢华的 a luxurious hotel. Okay, next important word, associate. Associate, connect in one's mind, 联想。我们常用的句式结构 associate A with B, 把 A 和 B 联想在一起。For example, I can't associate you with your wife. Can you associate snails with delicious food? 能把蜗牛联想成为美味佳肴吗？ Associate with 可以替换为 connect withLink with, okay? Or be bound up with, bound, B-O-U-N-D, be bound up with. Now next word, despise. Despise is a transitive word, regard as worthless. 认为什么是没有价值的。瞧不起，鄙视。For example, we despise him for a coward. 我们瞧不起他，把他看作是一懦夫。Coward, C-O-W-A-R-D. We despise him for a coward. Despise. 那么在口语当中我们更常运用 look down upon. For example, don't look down upon anyone. Now next, appeal. 引起兴趣。它必须和介词 to 搭配连用 appeal to somebody. For example, eating snails never appeals to me. Eating snails never appeals to me. 吃蜗牛从来没有引起过我的兴趣。Appeal 还表示上诉、呼吁。我们主要用于句型结构 appeal for something, 为某事而上诉。OK, now next, schedule.Slow walking for pleasure in street or in garden. 那么主要是在街道或者是庭院中的散步。Go for a stroll. Take a stroll. 这是常用句式形式。完全可以替换为 go for a walk. Take a walk. 散步人 Stroller. S-T-R-O-L-L-E-R. 请同学们注意以下的几个动词。Through 既是名词也是一个不及物动词。OK, now please listen to me. He's throughing along the road. 他正沿着马路慢慢地走着。我们要注意对比。Ramble, R-A-M-B-L-E, ramble, 与 through 接近，但它主要是指海岸林中的漫步。For example, the couple are rambling in the forest. OK, next, roam, R-O-A-M, 它主要指不安定的漂泊徘徊。The tramp roams every day.这流浪汉是每天漂泊不定。Next, wander, W-A-N-D-E-R, 流浪徘徊。He has nothing to do, so he is wandering along the street. Now please read with me the words here. Stroll, ramble, roam, wander. Next,impulse, in Chinese, 冲动, a sudden wish to do something. On impulse, 冲动的，这是我们非常常用的一个表达方式。He rushed out to catch up with the lady on impulse. He rushed out to catch up with the lady on impulse. 他冲出去去抓那位女士，她的这种表现得很冲动。Be driven by impulse to do something. Be driven by impulse to do something. 表示情不自禁的做某事。Oh, why did you do it? 你为什么这么做？ Oh, I should say I was driven by impulse to do it like this. 我应该说我是情不自禁。I should say, I was driven by impulse to do it like this. 请同学们牢记它的其他的词形。Impulsive, 冲动的 ,I-M-P-U-L-S-I-V-E. Impulsively, 冲动的。Now next important word, dozen. Dozen, a group of 12, 一打。A group of 12. 在运用这个词汇的时候，主要是常用于系列的短语。By the dozen, 成达的 by the dozen. We usually buy eggs by the dozen. Dozens of, 复数名词，表示泛指概念许多的，许许多多的。Dozens of students went to the cinema.那么如果表达具体的数词，比如说两打鸡蛋 two dozen eggs, 这个 dozen 只能运用单数形式。它的用法和 hundred, thousand 是一样的。OK, 一打玫瑰 a dozen roses。如果我们表示这些玫瑰中的一打，注意要介入一介词啊 ,a dozen of these roses。A dozen of the roses. 那么名词前 roses 要出现指示代词或定冠词。好，请注意一打玫瑰 A dozen roses. 这些玫瑰中的一打 A dozen of the roses. 在英文的口语当中，我们有一个很好的表达方式，请记好。Speak 19 to the dozen. Speak 19 to the dozen. 表示说个不停。So, go blah blah blah. The old lady is speaking 19 to the dozen. 这老太太一直说个不停。OK, next important word, fancy. Fancy, 喜欢喜爱。For example, I don't fancy living in the cold room. 我不喜欢住在这冰冷的房间里。I don't fancy living in the cold room. 那么 fancy 也表示想象设想，但是一种惊讶的心情，它是 imagine 的同义词。 imagine 和 fancy 都要和动名词搭配做宾语。 fancy meeting you here, 没想到在这儿见到你呢。 fancy meeting you here. fancy oneself 和反身代词搭配 fancy oneself 表示自以为是自命不凡 Do you fancy yourself? Okay, so much for the vocabulary. Now it's our time to study the text.
People become quite illogical when they try to decide what can be eaten and what can't be eaten.In this sentence, we know people are quite illogical when it comes to deciding what can be eaten and what can't be eaten.
那么在决定吃什么的时候不能吃什么的时候人们往往变得不合情理。
That is say, it is quite impossible for us to explain whyWe decide to eat this or that, and why we don't decide to eat the certain food. When we try to decide what can be eaten and what can't be eaten,
我们在表达这个语句的时候，请同学要注意，常可以用一个结构形式。当涉及到。那么在叙述这个客观事实的时候我们可以运用 come to something or come to doing something 常用于 when 所引导的时间状语从句